So, you're probably here because you saw my previous tutorial and you want to customize your chat overlay even more. If you haven't seen that tutorial, please check it out here. It's a tutorial on JChat, an awesome free Twitch chat overlay and has CSS tidbits in it. This tutorial is going to build on that one, with background images and animation. Let's go! The normal way to do this is to go to OBS, maybe add another browser source and customize the CSS straight away. But that's very annoying since the chat overlay resets to blank every time you press the OK button. So let's make this easier with some preparations. Go to JChat, get your chat overlay link and paste it. Next, go to your Twitch chat through your creator dashboard or your Twitch channel. Doesn't matter as long as you can chat. On Windows, click on your Twitch chat browser and press Windows left, the left arrow key, to send it maximized to the left side and Windows right on your JChat window. Sorry, I don't know how to do this on Mac and Linux, but you can resize your windows normally anyway. Next, on your JChat window, right-click on this blank slab of white and select Inspect Element. Select the body tag and click on this plus sign to add a new rule for the body element. Set the background color to whatever you want to simulate, since I doubt you'll want to test this with a pure white background. As you might be aware, this fake inspector style sheet in the Sources tab of Chrome is temporary, but will allow us to see our changes in real time. At the end of your styling, all you have to do is copy all your CSS to the OBS browser source. Be careful not to touch or override the original body selector of the browser source, since this tells the browser source that the body should not have a white background and have a transparent one instead. Let's start from scratch. Let's say you want to put a background image for your entire chat overlay like a wallpaper. In your chat container selector, add a background image property with the URL value. Put the location of your image inside the parentheses and enclose it with single quotes. Don't forget the semicolon after. Once you're done with the background image property, add another one called background repeat and set it to no repeat. Backgrounds are set to repeat or tile by default. Take note to check if your background image has a transparent or opaque background, especially if you have something like this. You may either want to remove the background and save it as a PNG, or get the color of your image and apply it to your container's background, or find something else. To add a border property, and set the style, width, and color. To make rounded corners, add a border radius property. If you need to make adjustments, there are properties called background size and background origin. You can look them up in W3 schools. I know it kind of defeats the purpose of a tutorial to tell you to just look it up, but yeah, lazy bum, sorry. If you need to make things more readable, you can put a semi-transparent background on the chatline class or on the user info and message classes individually. So apply it on the entire chat line because, let's say, you have a design for each chat line like this, add a chat line selector, and add the background image property into the chat line class. If you want to give some vertical space between the chat lines, add a margin top as well. If you still want a border on your entire chat container with this, remove the padding to remove the space between the chat container's border and the chat lines. Personally, I like separating the user info and the message into their own lines, so let's do that. Create selectors for the user info and message classes. Add a display block property to the message class to put it in its own line. Transfer the background image property from chat line to message. Before continuing, let's remove the colon by creating a selector for the colon class and adding a display none property. I'm going to remove the settings for the chat container, borders, and backgrounds. In the user info class, add a background color to subscribe so I'll know if this is interesting to you guys. Add padding and border radius if you like. For padding, I'm going to add 12px for top, 25px for right, 0 for bottom, 25px for left. For the border radius, 10px here and here, then 0 here. Again, remember that if you put only one number, it applies to all the sides or corners. If you put two, that's vertical and horizontal for sides, while it would mean top left, bottom right, and top right, bottom left for corners. If you put four numbers, that will be top right, bottom left for sides, then top left, top right, bottom left for corners. You can add padding and border radius on your message class if you want to. All right. Now here comes the neat part, animation. Now there are tons and tons of ways to do this. So please feel free to share them in the comments or in my Discord. Please stay with me as this may get a little technical. Good thing this isn't a classroom and you can always go back. I always tell people I don't like repeating myself more than 15 times.
Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! 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 Do it!
In this specific example, we'll make the chat line slide in from the right. First, let's add an animation property to the chatline class. I will put three values here. Like this video for the animation name, 0.8 seconds for the duration of the animation, and ease in out for the easing. This is a shorthand declaration and you can separate them into their own properties like this. Animation name, animation duration, and animation timing function respectively. I put a random-ish name for the animation name property just to let you know that you can use whatever you want. It's not a keyword. The animation duration is in seconds, but you can put decimals like I did. And lastly, the basic timing functions can be linear, ease, ease in, ease out, and ease in out. If you want to learn more or learn all of the possible values for each property, again, you can visit w3schools.com. I've been using this site as a dictionary probably since 2003 or something. Or just type in CSS animation in Google. Next, to set the details of the animation, we'll need to create add keyframes rules. Type in add keyframes, then the name of the animation you used a while ago. Inside, create a from rule and a to rule. In the from rule, add a transform property and set it to translate x 400px. This will set the origin of the chat line 400 pixels to the right of the original position. You may have to adjust this number as needed in your OBS scene. In the to rule, add the same, but set translate x to 0. Woo, yeah! Now let's add a subtle fade-in animation by adding opacity 0 to the from rule and opacity 1 to the to rule. Nice! Now let's add some subtle changes by sliding in the user's name from the bottom, then sliding their message from the right after some delay. I think this looks way cooler. That's, of course, my opinion.
Emotional damage!
Alright, I'm just making excuses to subliminally and subscribingly inject some more CSS lessons. Let's go! Add animation property to user info with the user entry animation name, 0.8 seconds duration, and ease in, out, easing. Add another animation property to message. I'll just copy and paste then change the name. For now, nothing will happen because we haven't defined what user entry does. So let's do that. Add keyframes user entry. Add a from keyword. Add a transform property and set it to translate y 40px. Then add a to keyword. Set transform to translate y 0. The from selector sets this element to start 40 pixels below its original position with transform translate y 40px. Note the positive number. You can try using minus 40px to make it slide down instead. The to selector then sets it to its original position with transform translate y 0. Let's test it out. Cool. Next, we'll fade them in by adding opacity 0 to the from selector and opacity 1 to the to selector. Nice. The from and to keywords are called keyframe selectors, and these are just easier ways to specify start and end properties. Oh, you can actually replace them with percentages if you want more advanced animations. Maybe I'll find another excuse to use them in another tutorial in the future. Maybe in 15 years or something. Hey, sir, you forgot about that subtle dilly-dally you mentioned. Oh, right. Go to the animation property of the message class and add 0.3 seconds at the end. This is the animation delay property. You can specify this separately like this if you wanted. If you notice, there's this annoying effect where the message starts out visible, then immediately blinks out before animating. Let's fix this by setting the initial opacity property of the message to 0. The new problem is that it goes back to 0 opacity after the animation. So let's freeze the animation at the end by adding forwards at the end of the animation property of the message. This is the animation fill mode, which, again, you can specify separately since the shorthand values can get confusing. And perfect. Now, copy all your CSS, then go to OBS, add a browser source or edit your existing one, double-click, paste your CSS, and test out your chat. Alright! If you lost the original properties of the body element, don't worry. You can just make a new one, copy those CSS settings, and paste them at the top. And because you stayed till the end, here's some bonus fun stuff. Go to the message entry keyframes rule. Change the transform property from translate y to rotate 0, and then rotate 360 deg. Please don't forget the deg unit. Rotation is always in degrees, dear students. Remove the opacity properties. Go to the message class now and add an animation direction property with infinite for its value. Let's remove its wobbly-bobbly thing by changing the animation timing function from ease in out to linear. Great! Wait, now I don't feel great. Anyway, please feel free to browse my other tutorials while I throw up or something.